So welcome back to the channel. Hope you're doing well. This video is all about my current health issues, some information just on atrial fibrillation or AFib, and yeah, kind of how it started for me, how it's currently going. So it's been quite a tough road the last couple of months. I thought I'd share that information with everybody, my supporters. Put it out there over social media, but here on the channel I'm going to explain exactly what it is, kind of exactly how you can go about fixing it, steps and ways of managing AFib. I hope this video is going to help people out there that have it. A lot of people do get this type of condition. It's not uncommon. It's one of the most common heart-related conditions out there for professional athletes as well as the average person. Generally more towards the senior ages, people the direction of 60 years old and kind of older get this type of heart arrhythmia or AFib. Hope this video is going to help people and give people some information, some insight into how you can manage it as well as the different steps you can take to try and get it fixed. We're currently on the journey of getting that done, so I'm kind of in the thick of it right now. Hope everyone's going to enjoy this video and it can help everyone out there that has this condition or people that just would like to know some more information about it. So if you do enjoy this video and you enjoy my content, please go ahead and please like the video. It'll help the channel so much. Subscribe if you enjoy my videos and comment if you have anything to say about this video or other videos. It would be super cool. So cool, with that out of the way, let's head straight on to the main part of this video. So let's start straight off with atrial fibrillation, or also known as AFib. There's a lot of different types of heart arrhythmias out there. I don't know all of them. All I can do is give you the information on the one that I currently have and the one that's kind of, you know, definitely put things on hold for me this year a lot. And with the Olympics coming around in the next couple of weeks, you know, it's been very, very tough on me psychologically, physiologically, a lot of things altogether. So I'll just share my experiences, explain how it started type of thing. We don't know the exacts of how it started, but I'll show the onset and how things began right at the start. Because I'm not a doctor, but yeah, I'll definitely just kind of, you know, keep it as basic and simple as I can so everyone understands where we're going with it. So yeah, obviously you get the signals in your heart, electrical signals that tells your heart when to pump, how to function, how to stay in a rhythm. And AFib is more or less a part of your atrium or atrial, and that pretty much sends a signal through to the rest of your heart. If your atrium is not functioning correctly, what happens is it can send the signal through to your heart incorrectly, and your heart then pumps at a different rhythm. You have two different signals or signals sending into your heart, which kind of makes your heart go out of sync. And if you think of it as an engine, it's almost like your engine going out of tune or out of sync, and your engine's actually not functioning correctly. And that's more or less what's happening with me, more or less what happens with people who have atrial fibrillation. This can come from many, many different things related to, usually, generally it's conditioned with health, so alcohol, overweight. A lot of different conditions can lead to atrial fibrillation. The one that I have is most likely due to endurance sports or kind of sports-induced AFib. And this kind of happens with a lot of top endurance athletes, Olympic athletes. It's not very uncommon for Olympic athletes or really, really top athletes to get this. And it can come around more or less just from many, many years of high intensity or HIIT type of training, as well as racing, pushing yourself inside out year on year, can kind of cause your heart to go into an arrhythmia. We're thinking that that might be the case. It's quite a tough thing to know that, you know, me perhaps pushing myself year in, year out might have caused a little bit my heart issues. It is a little bit scary. Luckily, most of the cases, it is pretty harmless. You kind of go into arrhythmia. Then you have two options you can do to try and get that fixed. The first option generally is cardioversion. So they go in and they pretty much shock part of your heart. They put two electrodes on the side, and it sounds scary. It's a pretty simple procedure. People go and get it done all the time in hospital. And you go there, they shock your heart kind of back into a rhythm. They kind of look at the part where your heartbeat is more regular. They kind of shock you there. They do it over 5 minutes and it puts you back into sinus rhythm or normal heart rhythm. And this makes you feel a lot better once they do that. The second option then they have medication as well. So they have kind of arrhythmia type of drugs or medication. They give you those kind of medications, and within, you know, a couple of hours, hopefully, or a day or so, you're back into normal sinus rhythm and your body's functioning better then, which definitely, definitely helps. The third, there's actually the third version one, and that's ablation. So it's kind of a, a minor operation where they go in kind of by your hip. They go up an artery or a vein. I'm not sure which one it is. But they go up into your heart and they kind of burn kind of the nodes, the parts that send the signal to your heart. And they kind of stop the signal that's getting your heart out of a rhythm. They kind of try and block it or stop it by making some scar tissue there in your heart. Sounds pretty scary. It is technically heart surgery. And those are the three options. So, you know, it's arrhythmia of the heart. Generally, it's not a big problem. You need to get your heart back into rhythm as soon as you can within 48 hours. Otherwise, the blood can kind of get stuck in your heart. And if the blood gets stuck in your heart, you can get things like stroke and heart attack and certain types of problems with your heart. So that's definitely something you want to try and get your heart back into rhythm as soon as possible to kind of eliminate getting those things like a stroke or heart attack, which you do not want. So yeah, it sounds like a very, very scary condition, but in the hindsight of it, you need to manage it. And you need to obviously try and figure out the triggers that cause you to have your AFib as soon as possible. I obviously stopped, you know, drinking coffee, which I really, really love. I stopped drinking the coffee just because it's a stimulant. So things like alcohol, stimulants, and those things are really not great for your AFib. I've had to stop with that. So I've stopped with those things. I've kind of cut the training down quite a lot. The intensity on the training, I've had to cut back really a lot. And for me, obviously, for training and that stuff, AFib is really a limiting factor for, you know, professional athletes or Olympic athletes. Not being able to push yourself as hard as you can definitely limits your ability to train well and to train as well as you can. So hence, that's a really problem to do with racing. Training has been very, very tough. So that's definitely something to factor in. Make sure that you're training within yourself and yeah, just make sure that you don't overdo things. So I'll go to my story, how AFib happened for me the first time, how I saw the onsets or how I saw things happening right from the start and how I started to notice that something was wrong right at the start. To kind of having two or three episodes of AFib now currently already and kind of the decision I've made from there as a professional athlete. I'll start right off with the first time that it happened. Days before, I kind of felt some heart palpitations and things coming into it happening the first time. And I kind of wasn't certain what it was. It was generally going to the training session after doing the first training session. And I think after having my heart rate up at a certain level, it came back down, and what happens is sometimes your adrenaline levels still stay up high and your heart rate's trying to recover. And what happens here is the extra heartbeats sometimes come back, or sometimes your heart arrhythmia kind of starts to kick in after you've done some training. That's what I noticed what happened for me. The arrhythmia kind of came in a tiny bit after training, which was interesting. It wasn't during training, but after training. So that was quite a scary feeling, but it started to happen about 4 days before I noticed something wasn't right. The first time I really noticed there was a problem, I was in the swimming pool. We were going for a swim. Luckily, I actually had my Form swimming goggles, which have my heart rate in it. And I could see automatically my heart rate was going up way, way too quickly, you know, much higher than usual. And normally I didn't think too much about it, but I stopped. I checked my heartbeat just with my fingers, counted 6 seconds, how many heartbeats I count on in 6 seconds. And then I could see that my heart rate was at about 160, 170, which was definitely in the incorrect range. And that definitely put some concern for me. And I noticed something wasn't feeling great in my chest. We went straight to the hospital and they obviously diagnosed me with atrial fibrillation. And that was, you know, quite an extremely big shock to me. You know, the doctors and them told me there that my professional career was finished. I can go and get a normal job, is what I was told. And you know, for me, hearing that from a doctor was very tough and something that's, you know, still stays with me tiny bit psychologically. So that happened the first time. Yeah, from then I got some good training done, took medication, but then it came back a month later again. And, you know, that was another big setback, extremely, extremely tough. I then obviously went and had cardioversion after that, where they went and they kind of shocked my heart back into rhythm. And then after that, it happened a week later again after doing some training. So we've made the decision now to have an ablation done, which they kind of go in, as I said, they go in with a catheter and they burn a little part of your heart. And hopefully this is going to fix my problem. And, you know, I'm really hoping that that's going to be able to allow me to compete as an athlete, a professional athlete again. And I hope this information helps you out. After I get the ablation done, I'm going to see how things go training wise. Whether I can compete in the Olympics or not is still a massive question mark for me. And I'm going to obviously do everything. I want to try and be as healthy as I can. I don't want to push myself. Health always comes first. That's number one. As a professional athlete, you must know your health comes above everything else. And so, yeah, I'll see how things go. Hopefully, I can compete in the Olympic Games this year. If not, perhaps we'll be looking at Paris 2024, which, you know, is only 3 years away. So we'll see how it goes. But I hope this information helps you, anyone out there with AFib. And if anyone has any comments, please drop them down in the comments section below. And I'll be able to get back to everyone who has any questions on it. I've heard a lot of people have had this condition before, so it's good to know that. And just remember that you're not the only one out there to have this condition. It is very scary, this condition, but just realize that it is manageable and you need to kind of do everything you can and try and, you know, try and be as happy as you can with the situation. It does suck, but yeah, you need to try and figure out all the different variables and figure out what you can do about it. But yeah, stay in there. Everything will be okay. And yeah, hope everyone's doing well. Cheers, everyone.